This next example is easier explained using pictures, so let's kind of see what we have here. So I'm gonna have a black rod, and it has length 1, and it is rotating around the origin, kind of like what we are looking at here. And as it rotates around, it will form this green rectangle where the two sides is on the x and the y axis, and this black rod is gonna be its diagonal. Now, I would like to find how fast the area of this green rectangle change with respect to the blue angle that I have here. So if we look at what we have, I knew that the area of the rectangle is going to be the width times the height of my rectangle. So far, I don't see any angle theta in here. So the area depends on the width and the height of my rectangle. But we can kind of see that as the rod rotates around, the width and the height of my rectangle is going to depend on the angle theta that we have. So then I'm going to have that the width and the height here, they both depend on the value of theta. So then to find how fast the area change with respect to the angle, I can find how fast the area change with respect to the width and how fast the width change with respect to theta, and then kind of combine that. I do the same thing. I find how fast the area change with respect to the height, how fast the height change with respect to theta, and then kind of combine that. So let's kind of do what we have here. I'm gonna need to first find this blue arrow. This blue arrow is gonna be how fast the area change with respect to the width. However, I know that the area is just width times height. So if I take the derivative of that with respect to w, I'm gonna just get the h here. So h is gonna be how fast the area change with respect to the width of my rectangle. Now for the other pink arrow, this is gonna be how fast the area change with respect to the height. So I just need to take the derivative of a with respect to h. And because my a is just w times h, so this is going to be just w. So this w is going to be how fast the area change with respect to the height of my rectangle. Now, to find how fast the width of my rectangle change with respect to theta, let's kind of take another look at the rectangle, I mean at the triangle that we have here. So let's say I'm going to have my green angle theta here. So then I'm gonna have this right triangle where the width is gonna be over here and the height is gonna be over here. However, I knew that the length of my rod is 1, so I can say that my width over 1 is gonna be just cosine of theta. And now I can take the derivative of this equation with respect to theta. I'm gonna have that dw by d theta is gonna be just the derivative of cosine, which is gonna be negative sine. So I knew that how fast the width change with respect to the angle theta is gonna be just negative of sine theta. So I'm gonna have negative of sine theta here. And now for the last arrow, I need to find how fast the height of my rectangle change with respect to theta, and I can use the same picture here. I see that if I divide h by 1, that's going to be the same as cosine, I mean the same as sine of theta. I can take the derivative with respect to theta, so what I'm going to have is, I'm going to have that dh by d theta is going to be just the derivative of sine, which is a cosine. So, this tells me how fast h, which is the height of my rectangle change, with respect to the angle, to the green angle theta here. So I'm gonna have that dh by d theta is gonna be cosine of theta. Now then, all I need to do is to combine all this together. And the way that I'm gonna do that is, I'm gonna say that dA by d theta, this is how fast the area change with respect to theta, it's gonna be just my blue number, which is h, times the purple number, which is negative sine of theta, negative sine of theta, plus the pink number, which is w, times the green number, which is cosine of theta here. And this thing actually has a name. It is called a multivariable chain rule. And the formula is basically what we have just written down. If f is a multivariable function and the value of f depends on x and y, and this x and y actually depends also on t, then derivative of f with respect to t is going to be derivative of f with respect to x, which is going to be this arrow, df by dx, which is fx here, times dx by dt, which is going to be this purple arrow here. This is going to be dx by dt, plus derivative of f with respect to y, which is going to be this pink arrow here. This is derivative of f with respect to y, and the last term, dy by dt, is going to be this arrow here. That's going to be the derivative of y with respect to t.